Look at the little, ooh, this is really cool. This was my idea, this whole Sultan Vision thing, my idea. But we thought there'd be more fish coming across, but it, look at that, woo. Oh, wow, that's cool. Okay, turn off the Sultan Vision now. I mean, you know, we're not trying to make fun. We have great sympathy for all you people in Sultan and Snohomish. You're underwater, it's, of course, that's big news, but there was other big news this week, which was good news for drivers, bad news for hitchhikers, which the 55-mile-an-hour speed limit. It's all gone, it's gone, you know, it's like... States can set their own limits. That's going to be so great around Seattle, isn't it? Everybody's sitting on I-90 and 405, sitting there all stuck, going like, wow, this is great. Wasn't for all this traffic that's been here for 20 years, we could be going 70 miles an hour. Why not make it 1,000 and we can just dream? It's great. So I guess it's going to be like 65 or 70 around town, maybe 75 down around Kent, Needham Claw, just for tractors down there. 90 in Tacoma, 120 on the Microsoft campus. They got a lot of sports cars over there. 13 in Ballard. It's going to be great. Give it up there, Ballard. Although, back to the news at hand, the big news with America watching us. Unfortunately, here we are in this part of the country on the verge of being able to legally drive as fast as we want. But it's going to be, everything's underwater. All the roads are going underwater. It's so hard. Look, this is the way people are driving right now, you know, because the limits are still enforced. That's in the Snohomish area, Highway 2 or something. But now, when the limit is removed, they're going to be driving like this. Like that. That's when the limit goes away. Now, granted, it's going to be tough learning how to drive that fast, you know, with the water that's going to be, it's going to be like Water World around here. It's going to be like that. But luckily, we happen to have living in our area the world's foremost expert on driving through water, and he's here to share some of his knowledge with us. So please welcome hydroplane legend Chip Hanauer. Chip, are you back there?
I hope I can help out here, you know, because driving on the water can actually be a lot of fun if you know what you're doing. First of all, you need to get your car a sponsor. Perhaps, you know, perhaps a little microbrew or something. The other thing is, you know, the stickers they put on the car, you know, to, you know, the advertising, well, it makes the car less porous. And weather like this, that's important. And incidentally, in my opinion, I think it makes the car look pretty damn cool. You know, as long as you follow these rules, as long as the roads are all covered, everything will be fine. The first rule is, you know, Volkswagens, well, now they're buoys. Just think of them. When you get to them, just turn on them. Number two, please, don't get on the freeway until you hear the 5-minute gun. Then hit it hard. Number three, don't drive a Miata over 70 miles an hour because they blow over backwards. Trust me, I know. Number four, if the engine dies, don't panic. Simply get out of the car, stand on the hood, the Coast Guard will be right by, hand you a beer. Get inside. This is a fun one because, you know, if you do get home first, take a victory lap around the rent S-curves. You know, you deserve it. And maybe, you know, get home and spray the family with some champagne. You know. But the most important rule is the race isn't over until I win.
Some wise, wise advice for those of you living up there in the Snohomish, in the floodplain, which was an interesting place to buy a house when you think about it. Anyway, but no, but we have, you know, our complete sympathy. I'm not saying that. Each year, as you know, there is some danger of flooding in those areas, but it rarely gets this bad. And to give you an idea of just how serious it's been this week, the rats are leaving Sultan. Even the rats, which is very serious. Oh, the little rats. Oh, yes, the outpouring of sympathy for the rats. Well, King 5 News has done a great job of covering the floods, and some of the dedicated reporters are still out there, and we want to keep you updated, so let's go live now to Jim Foreman. Jim, can you hear us out there?
Joe, I'm standing here on the porch of the car!
Well, oh, what happened to the rats, Jim Foreman, that's great. Looks like Jim's having a little problem, but, you know, we hope it doesn't damage the trench coat too much. So anyway, I think we have a live hookup, I think, with Bill Prasad, who's downtown. Bill, are you down there?
That's right, John, I'm standing in,
oh, my, well, gosh. I guess we'll have to check back with those folks in a few minutes. That, by the way, was from the King 5 Tower Cam. We have everything. We have the Tower Cam. We have the Doppler, which is going crazy. Anyway, in the meantime, some other strange things have been happening around the country. One of them has been documented in this made-for-TV movie. Take a look.